Let's start the video out with a mood of repentance here. Staying humble, realizing, start out and say, I have a severe continuity problem. Very severe, so this is what I'm going to focus on. I know the remedy is the vision of oneness, so we're going to focus on the vision of oneness. Give a little time to get serious. Very sober. Realizing this is really important, especially now. It's always really important, especially now when there's a concerted effort to crush our will to do right spiritual practice. What do I mean by right spiritual practice? It means effective spiritual practice. It doesn't mean trying to get something for the personality. No way. But our aim is way beyond that personality, entirely beyond that. So our aim is a pragmatic one, and that is effectiveness. So that's what right spiritual practice is all about. So we start out and say, I have a very severe continuity problem. Now in this ideological battle that's taking place in the world, to win this battle means to actually use your will to continue right spiritual practice, effective spiritual practice, which means it moves us closer to the vision of oneness. The vision of oneness is most certainly there for us. The big question is abiding in it. Okay, so we're going to directly melt away this block with this video. Abidance in the vision of oneness. We can get a glimpse of it, but who's abiding in it? That's the question. Well, we're supposed to be, and we will be. It's very simple, actually. Now, each morning when you wake up, the task is to ask the grace of God, by whatever name you want to refer to it, to provide you with the right spiritual exercise for that day, whatever it is. The words, give me the words. I just say, Holy Spirit, give me the words that I need to focus on today, the exercise I need to focus on today. Now, it's very important to point out that the first couple of steps of getting started on your day with the right spiritual exercises, that's the hardest part. And once you get past those first two steps, the day is going to be a success for you. But it can be quite a battle to get through those first two steps. Sometimes it takes me an hour or two. I haven't been sleeping much lately. Waking up at 4 in the morning, and I just stay awake and thinking. Finally, I get around and say, you know what? Ooh, I've got a severe continuity problem. What's the right spiritual practice for the day? And then eventually it pops into my mind. I say, oh, that would work. That's really good. Oh, that's perfect. And then get started on it. So each day we need to start out the day with using our spiritual will. Don't let the day dictate to us how we're going to use it. That's how you win the battle. You dictate to the world how you're going to use your day, and you're going to use spiritual will on your day, throughout the whole day. Not personality will, spiritual will. So, a lot of us are feeling like there's no hope. There's no hope. How can we possibly win this? And there's definitely a way. Most definitely a way. The vision of oneness is the win. It's a big, big win. It's a huge win. Crushes the ego. The ego feels so, you know, deflated. When anyone enters and abides in the vision of oneness, that is devastating to the ego. Absolutely devastating. The ego feels defeated, which is good. The ego cannot stop us from right spiritual practice. All we have to do is to summon our will, and we can do it. But again, the struggle to get started in the morning, each morning, or at any time you're ready to get started, morning's the best time, so you set the tone for the day. It can be very difficult. And the ego keeps trying to get you to do something else. It's difficult for me, it's always difficult. It's never easy, really. And you may start out the day with some words, and then as the day goes, they refine. They refine, you get better and better and better and better and better. Today, it started out with, the vision of oneness is what I really want. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. Okay, it started out, and it didn't feel quite right. It felt good, but not quite right. So I kept working on the day, and I finally came up with what was just right. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. And that clicked in, I said, that's it. That's the most powerful spiritual exercise I've ever done today. It has it all. Because when I say the vision is oneness is mine to keep, that's addressing the abidance issue directly, right? It's mine to keep. It's a free gift from God. It's mine to keep. It's not something that I look at and then give back. It's mine to keep. This is super important. But then we think, wait a minute, what do I do with all the past? You know, all this dream of a past, something before God, something that happened before God, how God came into being, this was some past before. What do we do with that? What do we do with that? It belongs to the Holy Spirit. We give it over to the Holy Spirit. It says, it's yours. This is my gift to you. I'm exchanging gifts. You're giving me the vision of oneness. I'm giving you the past. Now, we don't own it anymore. It belongs now to the Holy Spirit to do whatever it wants to do with the past. Tremendous relief, burden off our shoulders. So the vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. So this became the practice of the day. And I've been using it all day. And I find it's just an absolutely incredible practice. And now the personality, of course, doesn't understand this. It says, what do you mean by the past? What do you mean? What is this? It's okay. Just keep doing it. I just ignore it. Say, the vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. You can do a threefold form on the beginning. You could say, only the vision of oneness has value. The vision of oneness is what I really want. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. So everything is accounted for right there. And it dramatically changes the entire landscape, spiritual landscape, I guarantee you. Because you look at the vision of oneness differently now, and you realize it's for me, it's mine to keep. I just keep it. There's the abidance right there. It's mine to keep. It's not mine to fumble away or say, I don't deserve it. I don't, whatever. It's mine to keep. It's a free gift from God. It's mine to keep. The only price we pay is we give the past to the Holy Spirit. We give the past to the Holy Spirit. So, the ego constantly tried to interfere today with this. And I just kept going back to it. No, the vision of oneness is mine to keep. Past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. Now, I may attach a practice session after this video to this video. It may be a long one where people can just tune in, listen, and try to go along as their thoughts pop into their head, as they will. Pull yourself back, pull your mind back, say, oh, wait, no, the vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. So whatever issue is coming up, it's about, quote-unquote, the past. You no longer own the past. It belongs now to the Holy Spirit, so you don't really have anything to do with it. It's not yours to worry about anymore. What you have now is the vision of oneness. So the vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. This is one of the most powerful declarations that can ever be said. And so it's a great way to start out our counter-offensive, as it were, towards the adversary in this world, which has declared war, basically, has declared war on right spiritual practice, God's plan of salvation has declared war on it at this point and intends to crush it here in this world. So our counteroffensive is to make this powerful declaration. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. This is just an unbelievable, you know, counteroffensive, as it were, that just, you know, pushes the ego back on its heels for sure. Globally, that this is such a powerful statement. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. Done. That's it. Done. There's nothing the ego can do to counter this. All right. It's all the ego can do is to undermine our will so we don't practice it. That's all the ego has. It doesn't have anything else. So it's totally about summoning your will to actually make these declarations, because once we're making them, it has this profound effect. I went to bed last night, lay down, and I said, okay, I'm willing to have my whole mind rearranged and aligned properly right now. And then I experienced something, some sort of sensation throughout my whole system. And I said, wow, I've never experienced this before. So something happened. I don't know exactly what. At some level, there was something really profound happened to me last night. So we will see what that is. But then it came up, this declaration was given to me this morning. It is the counteroffensive. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. Mine to keep. I'm going to keep it. It's mine to keep. Vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. I'm done with it. It's off my hands entirely. It's off my hands entirely. And the Holy Spirit will answer for us in whatever needs to be answered. Of course, the Holy Spirit knows there is nothing to answer to. But in our mind, we're worrying about that. But the Holy Spirit will answer for us if it is necessary. Absolutely, we'll say, I am now answering for this one. I will, and so you can trust, absolutely trust, that you don't have to worry about any the past whatsoever. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. All right. This sets us right back in the driver's seat now, okay? And it's necessary. Nobody can afford to go forward from this point on without being able to make great declarations, to summon their will and make great declarations. Nobody, because otherwise you're going to get swept away. It doesn't matter ideologically how clear you are. You have to make these great spiritual declarations, because this is the remedy for it. Absolutely is the remedy. The ego, it knocks it out. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. Finished. See? Done. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. Now, the vision of oneness is right there for us. I've been experiencing it recently on several occasions. And the only issue is abidance. That's the only issue there is. This directly addresses this. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The more you say that, the closer you get to actually keeping it. That's it's tremendous. I just have this realization, oh my gosh, this is the answer. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. One and done. This declaration, if you can do it, keep doing it, keep doing it, keep doing it, keep doing it. It can literally put you right there where you actually have the vision of oneness and you're keeping it. And the past now belongs to the Holy Spirit. And you are simply done. You don't have to do anything except just keep this vision of oneness. That's it. It's yours to keep. See, the vision of oneness is mine to keep. This is what God tells us. It's mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. I've given all the past to the Holy Spirit. Okay, so, if I can, I believe I will be able to. I'll do another taping later on this evening. And we will practice this more and just keep repeating it. Really, 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 really get into repeating it. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. Past belongs to the Holy Spirit. I've been doing it all day. It's an all-day sort of thing where I've been able to keep it going all day, which is unusual, really, for an exercise. It's usually very difficult. It lasts for a while and then fizzles. It's too difficult. This one has lasted all day. It seems to generate spiritual will in us, this, when we realize, oh my gosh, it's mine to keep. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. You feel the freedom in that statement, and that energizes your will. So this is a will-energizing declaration that the vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. Okay, very great. Let's see what we can do to attach another video to this one. Welcome to the practice session. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. So this is simply a practice session where what we do is we simply build up momentum, gather momentum. Instead of discursively talking about it, but we actually practice it. So, the vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. It's that simple. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. So we're off and running. The past, the vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. So the vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. Simple. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. Vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. And the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. So we started in a little bit. What are we finding? Well, finding resistance and the mind trying to wander off, and the effort to bring it back so it has meaning for us instead of just empty words. So it's very interesting to just notice the drifting of your will and keep working to bring it back so you have really clear feeling of will that yes, this is it. We'll try a little more. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. You ever seen those basketball players when they need to make a crucial free throw? You know, they bounce the ball. They focus. And then they really want to make that free throw. It's very important. It's like that. You got like a free throw. You've got to make that free throw. It's for the game. You don't want to just carelessly throw it up there. You want to make that free throw. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. So there's an exchange here. We're accepting something and letting it go at the same time. Okay? An exchange. So the vision of oneness belongs to me, is mine to keep. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. Past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. So what we do here is we try not to say it until we mean it. We have to mean it, right, with conviction. So we have to try and bring the attention and conviction to the statement instead of just absentmindedly saying it. Saying something absentmindedly is not going to work. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. This isn't for the lazy, is it? It requires really, it's a lot of work. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. Vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. Vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. It's in a restless mood. It's not getting into it, the program. It likes to reach over and snag my clothes and start pulling on it, knowing that'll get my attention. It's like the ego, right? Trying to snag our attention. So we bring ourselves back. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. Cat comes back like the ego saying, "I want to disrupt some more." God, what I can do is I can put the cat inside, right? So I'm going to do that so it doesn't disrupt us. One moment. Okay, now I'm going to pick up the pace. Let's try that for a while. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. All right. Vision of Oneness. Is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. Now let's go along at sort of medium pace. Let's try that. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. Okay. Man, this is very challenging to concentrate and don't let the thoughts wander, but keep them right present. Really, really, really challenging. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. No wonder why I tried to beg off this. I said, let me do some special effects tonight. Let me put together some documentary, you know, let me do some text, let me do this, easy stuff. I said, wow, I don't know, I think the Holy Spirit's gonna ask me to do something really tough. Wow. This is the toughest meditation I've ever done, for sure. But, you see, it's doable. digging deep, but it's doable. And it's time to do it. It's time to do it. We can do it. We can do it. You see, we're proving to ourselves. The only way we can succeed is to prove to ourselves that we can do it. Nobody else can prove it for you. It doesn't matter if somebody else does it. You still have to prove it to yourself that you can do it. Can you focus on this one idea, this one principle, and continually bring it into focus, and put your valuing there? Can you do it? Of course. Oh, man. Okay. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. See, it's not easy. It is not easy. It takes great effort to focus on this. I was doing better earlier in the day when I had more energy. But to sit down in a concentrated way like this and do it like this probably has tremendous effects. It's sort of burning a groove into your mind. And so we will see what kind of effects this has. It's interesting to find out what the next step will be. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. And the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. And the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. And the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. And the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. And the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. Vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. Past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. Vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. So this was using all sorts of forms of expression and attitudes, etc. And I found that the ego, after one or two times, was desperately trying to mimic it, you know, and say, okay, I got it, and then let me do it. And the focus was hard to keep going. It would sort of, first couple times would be feel really strong, and then it would sort of like fall off. Very interesting. How our will, how our assertion can begin to sag and deflate and feel like I'm losing the will here. The vision of oneness. See, you have to be quicker. You have to get ahead of the ego, or else it gets an idea of what you want to say, and then it jumps in to try and say it. That's why we shift practice. We're not training the ego. We're not training the personality how to say this. It's not in training. We're not trainers for that. We're not training the ego here. So when the personality jumps in and says, okay, I got it, okay, I'm ready to say it. Be silent then. Be silent that time. Don't say it. Be silent. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. As I had trouble there. So we're just noticing, just paying attention to what arises. Getting a little bit of a wall or some resistance. So just notice that. Let's see. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep. The past belongs to the Holy Spirit. Okay, well, it's getting difficult now, very difficult. So that's probably enough. But once it gets like this, so, very great. This was an excellent exercise. And it's right on time. It's due. Needed to do this. Needed to get this out there. Let people see the real deal as far as real effort goes. Let everyone see that it's necessary and possible to summon your will to a greater effort than before. And since we're new at it, we're a little bit out of breath at this point. And but once begun is half done, right? So we'll wrap this up now. And we can continue on. I'll continue on. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. The vision of oneness is mine to keep, and the past belongs to the Holy Spirit. So, you know, I'll continue on this evening. This was just a very concentrated effort here to prove to ourselves that we have what it takes. So those who, whatever, just trying to say otherwise, we can easily brush it aside, not even pay any attention to them, okay? That's what's important. Don't even have to pay any attention to them. We've already proved it to ourselves. Okay, very great. Great effort. And that's it for this video.